I would recommend that all players strap, either with these big ones if you're at a higher level of disability, but even if you're a one seat with good trunk, I'd recommend you strap with a low belt, because then what happens is you get that contact that's going to shove you forward and out of your chair, you're not going to go forward and out of your chair. Okay? And then finally, what else? And then Juan's going to wear gloves to protect his hand. Then we've got a bungee cord right there to stop the knees coming apart. Also, it's a nice little leg to rest the ball on. Okay? Find out what part that stuff works for you and what part doesn't. For the coaches, I really recommend white and a dark shirt to come. What we did was that we pulled these training tops for the players. They ended up costing like 18 or 20 bucks a pop, including all the logo and everything else on that. That way, your team's aware of your team identity, even in practice. No one can forget it, because it's an investment. And also, it's much easier to change shirts, but just take it off and turn it inside out. They're all reversible. That's something you might want to do. Okay, that's pretty much the individual player setup. The next thing that we're going to go to is we're going to go to our warm-up. Now, we're not going to spend so much time in warm-up as we would do at a regular practice, and that's because we've got a lot of stuff to get through. Now, what we would do stage one is people would come in, and everyone's going to come in at different times, but not too far separate, hopefully. And then first, it's just going to be informal, just get your body loose, get your body a little more. Then everyone should be stretched. You know, it's kind of, you know, in basketball, we're real bad on doing that sort of thing. With quads, when you've got less muscle involvement, also then you put more stress on those muscles. So really warm up, good stretching. I'm sure you've got that down. And then once you've done that, then you strap your people. Okay? You can't stretch them out real good if they're strapped in. All right. Now then, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go, we'll just push around a little bit just to warm up, and then we'll get into it. If you're comfortable, like, and you've got a little bit of momentum up, don't just drag on one wheel, because you're going to come around fairly slowly, okay? What I would suggest you try and do is, if you're comfortable, like, break a little bit, and then you can come better, and maybe use your other arm on the car, okay? Now, how are we going to be doing this is, you're going to come to the first line, we'll see the show.
Thank you. camera shots.
Thank you.
David Taylor likes this drill. David Taylor states he likes this drill. Well, he's certainly making a monkey out of himself. And it's all on film. I haven't even seen David Gold at this end of the court yet. There he goes. Oh, hobble. Sonya's here to help. Here's our star, David Taylor, making it to the final line of the court. And here's Goldie. Uh-oh, there's the pick on Goldie, and he got by him. Let's hope it's for good. All right. Scotty.
Nice work. Nice work. Everybody up front.
Does he? He needs to go a little faster.
It's like Chase. Like.
There's Terry consulting with the board.
Thank you.
guys sitting there at the back. Okay, what we're going to do first is we're going to do some ball handling relay. Okay? We would set this up as an individual drill first, but we don't have enough balls for all the 1Bs, we don't have enough space. So we're just going to go straight into the relay. B's and C's, you've got to handle the ball whilst you're in the relay. A's, you get the chance to push without the ball. So let's have this team in this lane, this team in the middle lane.
Thank you.
catching that girl.
I said, you see that up here somewhere? That was pretty good. Well, I'll let you call that again.
carries pretty. Terry.
Anybody come down on this thing?
We're now moving into, I guess, the first kind of strategy tactic side, and that's the pair, okay? What are you trying to achieve when you're executing the pair? You're trying to achieve two things. One is to get a guy isolated on the wrong side of his defense, okay? That's the first thing. What that does is, even if they can cover up, you can go down and get a 4-on-3, or 3-on-2, or in this case, we're trying to achieve a 2-on-1. Okay, that's the first thing a pick does, is it gives you more numbers. But the other thing it does is it forces the other team to switch. Because the only way to stop a pick is to rotate which man is taking which man on defense. Now what that means then is that you might end up with a 1A against a 1C, which is great for you. That won't happen too often, but it may happen that you end up with your 1C on their 1B. Or maybe your 1B on their 1C if your 1B is better. But what you want to be doing is you want to be working these picks as frequently and as often as you can, especially when the other team's full court pressing you, to change the numbers to give you an advantage. But right now what we want to do is we're going to set up the pick for a 2-on-1. Okay? Now, if these two guys are playing offense right here, and they're bringing the ball down on these guys, okay? Now, if these two guys are playing an honest, what we call an honest man-to-man, okay, so Steve is on the right, and me is up on the right, okay? Gabriel is playing smart. This occurs most often when the other team's pressing you, okay? What we want to see is the first thing we want to see is vertical separation of the pick, okay? You can't pick if the two defenders are on the same width of the court, on the same level as the width of the court. It just can't happen. So what happens is that one guy, white, is going to go deep, okay? And then his defender is going to go with him because they're full court pressing, okay? Then what happens is this guy comes back, and again, here's the other defender, is playing honest and up on Smiley. Okay? And then Smiley's going to come around. Now let's stop it right there. Really, the picture we set just a little bit more this way. That's good. Okay? Don't pick with your foot blades. It's not effective and you're going to hook. You want to try picking with your back wheels. Okay? Smiley's going to come around. Now if we take a picture of this right here, the first thing that's occurring is that this defender then has to take Smiley, when in fact his man is Dwight. That's going to cause a little bit of confusion. But more importantly, our offensive player is now goal side of this defensive player, which means when they separate, they bring it down to 2-on-1. Okay? That's the pick. It can be done 100 different ways, but it should be done with the back of the wheels, and you'll work out 100 different ways to use it in a game, but you've got to get down the basic mechanics. Now, after showing you that, we're going to do that with drill after this one. It can also be done to turn a 2-on-1 into a 1-on-1. Okay? So slide it, I'm going to slide it out, and then remember we do the 2-on-1 passes, the 2-on-1 kick is to see, why don't you come in front of offense? Okay, here's the level defender right here. Okay?
Now, situation,
can we have a ball? Can you give Stanley Steve the ball? Alright. Now, they're coming down to 2-on-1. The defender has to do something. Okay? Okay? So then what we can do is set a pick right here, get him good, right? And just keep him out. Okay? And then you go in straight and score 1-on-1. Let's do that one again. Let's score between the two cones. Okay? Okay? So then Gabe's the love defender, okay? You're the offensive
player. Terry.
Okay. Alright. Yes. Stick it real good. And then keep it right. Keep it. See what I mean? To create that 1-on-1. So that means you don't have to risk passing the ball. Okay? That's the beauty of it is you're going to isolate that one defender away from the ball. You don't have to pass the ball and the guy can score. So if we can go back and set up that 2-on-1 again,
Let's work on the kick on that 2-on-1 first, if we can, real quick. So back to your arms, let's do that.
Thank you.
out right away. Smiley and Scott, you guys are in offense. Want you guys to start from right here. And seven.
Another headache.
Get that back again.
Thank you. Say something to the camera. Say something to the camera. That was Lauren. Is going to have to be on the side. Somebody will.
So what we're doing here, we're kind of setting up a situation more realistic game time, and also cut down on the number of people that can be isolated. You have to realize that taking the two people to work together is not be here. Person's got to come and pass this line unless, cannot pass it unless there's an actual pit on me or somebody that's here. The next person, that same person comes down, there's going to be a 1A down here and another player. The 1A is always on the offensive side. So what happens is, got the ball and got to brush the next defensive player off the 1A. So the 1A has got to look at it from the standpoint that he can't be too close to the defender. He's got to separate a little bit. He can't be like behind the defender. He's got to move off a little bit, give the ball handler time to know where he is so that he can react to him. So what we're going to do is we're going to have to come down.
Set this up in 2 lanes. So 1 lane there.
There you go.
Watch their tour going on. And do what you want to do. There's Goldie.
Because we're trying to play it off, and we're looking at just the direction.